Hello, welcome to D-Light Channel. This week we are coming to about 10,000 feet above sea level as we land the last leg of the behavioral preparation. What does that mean? If you are new here, we've been focusing on retirement and how to prepare for it, and I've identified three umbrellas under which you need to prepare for retirement. The fourth has to do with the cognitive preparation. The second has to do with the behavioral preparation. Under behavioral, we have identified how you behave towards yourself, your family, your colleague, and those you meet in the course of work. And this week, we are now focusing on your behavior in the society. Now, this is very, very critical for you to pay attention to. Why? Let's play a scenario. When you retire, like we said in the beginning, you stop your active career life, your active day-to-day grind, meaning that while those who are still in active employment are rushing out 5 o'clock, 5:30, 6 o'clock, whenever, and they are back about 6 p.m., 7 in the evening, you are there not necessarily doing the grind with them. Then who keeps your company? Who will you be talking with? Who has your time? You will realize that the society in which you function, which will include things like the community in which you live, where your residence is based, your old students association, the church in which you worship, the mosque in which you worship, an NGO or something that you've decided to give your life to. These are the things that keep you productive. And I think it's a good point for me to flash some information for you about retirement. Research has shown that how well an individual lives post-retirement, how long an individual lives post-retirement, is a function of a number of things. Number one, whether that individual has any productive engagement. That's why you find old people who still have something to do, something as simple as helping their children to supervise projects, or even babysitting, or having some form of productive engagement. They tend to live long. Why? I said it before, there is something therapeutic about work. That's number one. Number two variable that affects the quality of retirement and old age is if you are having the right support structure, family, friends, colleagues, church, some form of availability that you can always count on, either when you need somebody to drive you around, somebody to take you to run some errand for you. That support structure, the quality of it, the availability of it, determines to a large extent how well and how long you will live post-retirement. Make that number two. Number three, that's also very important, is your level of self-esteem, which is why we started with your relationship with yourself. If you relate well with yourself and you have self-validation, your esteem will be very high. You won't judge yourself by the fact that your phone is no longer ringing off the hook anymore, because you realize that that phase is past, this is a new phase, and you are doing your best to find it. And last but certainly not the least is that you have a very good financial situation. So when you put all this together, you then realize why the quality of your behavior to the society in which you live is very important. Now, I know for a fact that right now, while you are busy with career, raising children, running after this project, that project, you may not have all the time now, but if you remember retirement, you will not completely shut it out. You will make yourself available as often as you can, as much as you can, so that when the graph of work or the graph of career begins to go down, you are conscious to immediately kick in the graph for the societal involvement. You offer yourself to serve. You make yourself available to help. You got money, you throw it in. You got skills, you throw it in. You got network, you throw it in. As you do that exchange between the time that career has taken to the time that societal investment and involvement begins to take, you are doing something powerfully important for yourself to have a very satisfying and rewarding retirement. So it is critical that as you are working now, whether you are just starting, you are mid, you are going towards the end, as you take care of the cognitive preparation, which we have listed, please watch the video if you cannot remember, and you take care of the behavioral requirements, which is what I just landed right now, you are doing something very important that will count for you down the line when it is time for you to retire. But there's one more umbrella we are yet to cover. That is one that most people focus on, and obviously it has to be important for you to get that level of attention. That is the financial umbrella. That's the bus stop we are moving to next week. And we will take our time to dimension it in different directions so that you will find a handle from which you can grab that one and run with it. And I hope you will make it a date with me next week. So until then, tell your friends, share it. Everybody prays to live long. Everybody wants to retire, but not everyone is aware of what it takes. That gap is what we are trying to bridge. And don't forget to send us some likes as well. It makes us very glad. But until I see you next week, don't ever forget, T-Mac is still my name. Dila is still the channel. And whatever you do, always remember that what we are here to do is what? Make a little difference. Have a fabulous time out there. Bye.